Hello. So in this video, we go over the steps on how to make an inexpensive storage container habitat for your arboreal gecko or any arboreal species, as well as visit a Reptile Expo.
All right. So this is going to become a habitat for my crested gecko that is pretty old. He's 10 to 12 years old, so. This is a 32 quart. Has the clips on there. Be real with you. I really don't like the plastic storage container habitats for reptiles, but I understand it. So this is a low cost way to do it. All right, so this is only $7. So the container was $7.87. So I'm gonna just, I can either cut this slit out right here, or I can cut these two out. Get more airflow. I know a lot of people like to put like cut holes on the sides to like get airflow. I mean, that's the way to do it. I never really done it that way. Well, not on nothing like this. I like to cut the had like a vent in the lid. I don't know. We'll see. I might cut a flow in the back, but normally I like to do it because it keeps the humidity and moisture in for most of them, because a lot of times I use this with my tropical species or my arboreal species. I know you see this, you want to go on this way, but I'm going to cut on the inside of this, so that way when I use this glue, I have something to glue it to. So let's see, just so I use a window screen, and this is gonna be hard because, as you see, I had it rolled up for a long time, so now I have to battle with trying to like straighten it out. All right, just got to the Biltmore Motel. It's about to be my first expo for Reptile Expo for 2021. Haven't been to one since I came here in 2019. So yeah, I'm about to check it out, see how it looks. My only probably products or purchases I might make today would be like cork bark or like cleaner insects or feeder insects. So let's check it out.
Last up, don't really have too much high expectations, but I might as well to be fooled.
Pretty
good. Looking for anything in particular? They're just thinking to be like. There was no, I'm gonna donate some money because I never leave for anything. But it's all good. Don't just get something. Okay, so today is done. I'm going to add my crescent in there, and then I'm also talking about what's in the deli cup.
Bro, what the? Sprinklers keep living down here in the south, man.
Fam, say you want all the smoke. Get your Try to go for my toes. Get your Yeah, see that flips you on your back now. Damn's under stress. Shut up. Boom. So that's the finished product. It's been in here a couple of months now. And they need to clean up his cage. He's very active in there. See if I can scoop him out with a spoon. Oh, the shoulders. So I'll glue both sides. Double it. Just in case something wants to get on there and like pull on it or hang on it. If I can spoon him out. How you feel today, boy? How you feel today, old man? Oh, he's active. Look at him. Look at him run. Come on. Hang on there. There you go. Ah, oh, there he is. Look at this handsome young man. My little old man. I love the copper in his eyes. You feel, there you go. I mean, like, change the camera angle. little buddy. All those crickets in the background. But you see, he's putting on weight good now. And that's the thing, when I first got him, he wasn't eating too well. He was real skinny. So I have to keep playing with habitats for him. And so far, him actually being in a plastic container has worked good for him. When I have him in a glass exoterra, he wouldn't eat or anything. So that's the benefit. I still have the setups for him, just in case he does want to go into the exoterra one of these days and behave. I don't say behave, but actually eat. So, that's a setup. Have a tree in here. That's a magnetic clip. Have some magnolia leaves in there that he hides out in. A little bit of cocoa fiber in there. I throw isopods in there every once in a while to eat the fecals. But I think he snacks on them, to be honest with you. But I'm going to go ahead, get him some gecko diet for today. And until next time, I'll holler. If you have any like good names, you should drop them in the comment, because I really don't have a name for this guy. But yeah. That is what dude, Dalmatian.